My name is Megan Bruck Syal. I'm a postdoctoral researcher here at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory. I work on planetary defense with a team of researchers here. Today I'll be opening a box from Johnson Space Center, which they sent us. It has some very special cargo in it. It has meteorites, which we are going to use for some experiments later on this year. At the Jupiter Laser Facility. All right, unboxing meteorites from NASA's Johnson Space Center. Here we go. All right, here we are. Got the first layer open. Now, just gray padding all around the rocks so that they don't move much while in transit. Take that off. And now we have a smaller box, which we can take out. Meteorites are inside of here. So open this little box. Okay, got the little box open. Lots of bubble wrap to keep them safe. Very exciting. And now they're in this vacuum sealed plastic pack. And they're in these little clamshells of aluminum foil. With their labels attached as well. Here's the first one. And here's its label. It says MIL07052,6. That's the name of this particular meteorite. And take a look at the rock itself. So these are collected in Antarctica by a dedicated research team that hunts for meteorites every year. I don't know which season in particular these were found in, but they've found something like 16,000 different samples over the last 30 years down in Antarctica. And here's our other sample. This is ALH84069,33. And these are just ordinary chondrites, so they're the most common type of meteorites. And that's why they're of particular use to us, because if we are interested in deflecting an asteroid, we want to know more about their material properties. And these are the most common types of rocks that we would expect to be dealing with if there was a potential impactor. And knowing more about these rocks' specific material properties is of great interest to us. So we're very grateful that NASA has been generous with us and allowed us to use these rocks in future experiments at the Jupiter Laser Facility.